In this video, I'll show you how to inline an SVG element directly into your website. The first thing you need to do is open your SVG into a text editor. I have an SVG stored on my web server, so I'm just going to go to the link and view the page source. If you've never seen an SVG in a text editor before, you'll immediately notice that it looks a lot like HTML. What we can do then is copy the SVG elements and paste them directly into our HTML page. The main pro of doing this technique is the flexibility it provides. We can use CSS to style the SVG, adding colors, animations, and more. We can also use JavaScript in the SVG elements if we want to. There are a few cons of doing it this way, though. The first one is maintenance. If a change is made to the SVG, you need to go back to everywhere that the SVG was inlined and make the same change there. The second downside is network performance. Unless you have a static HTML page, most likely you're not caching the HTML retrieved by the server. This means that the SVG code needs to be downloaded each time. Lastly, if your SVG elements contain IDs, you may run into issues with ID resolution on other HTML or SVG elements. A lot of these problems can be fixed using my favorite SVG technique, SVG symbols. We'll go over them in the next episode.